strange. If there were a world dragon soul here, there would be some sort of shrine to house it.
Brother, are you sure your reports were reliable?
My apologies, Kirka. I lied. There's no dragon soul here.
Wait, what? What the hell are you doing? This is no time for...
This is the only time. Here we can minimize the casualties if the worst should come to pass.
What?
Everyone but the Shining Dragon stand clear. If he loses control...
What are you going to do to Yuma?
I warned him. If he lost control of his power again, I would kill him myself.
You mean... when we talked before.
And so you failed. You lost yourself to the Shining Dragon's rage. Astoria could have been reduced to rubble.
What are you saying? He can control it. Astoria is safe.
For now. But this is the second time he has lost control. The boy lacks experience. He's too unstable. Only a fool would trust him to wield the Shining Dragon's might. I intend to eliminate him before he can do any more damage. The Shining Dragon's power has already annihilated an entire village. I will not see that tragedy repeated.
What? A village was destroyed?
That's right. There was a boy like you who carried the Shining Dragon within him, but he lost control. Innocents were killed.
I never knew. A whole village. Yuma, don't listen to him. It doesn't matter, okay?
No. I think his fear is justified. I know exactly how terrifying the Shining Dragon's power can be.
Do you?
What the hell are you saying? You're not seriously gonna let this guy take you out!
Before all this, I might have. But not anymore. The Shining Dragon and I stand together. We won't let that happen.
How can you be sure?
I know how to use its power now. And I'm going to use it for my friends. No, for everyone in the world.
Bold words, if you can stand by them. You believe you can control it. You think you can deny the rage.
I know I can!
Fine then. Prove it to me.
The winter winds howl through my fang and echo across all creation. I am Lestin Sarah Alma, the Glacier Sentinel. Let's see what the vessel of the Shining Dragon can do.
Let's go!
strike!
It's over. You're a far cry from the stuttering boy in the royal court. What changed in you?
I have my friends. Sonya, who believes in me. Kirika, who sees me for who I really am. Agnum, who always has my back. Marion, who always speaks her mind. Rinna, who always cheers everyone up. And Fromage, too. No, it's not just them. The king, Captain Burroughs, Emma, Primula, everyone in town. They're all important to me now. I know now that whatever power tries to control me, it'll never be as strong as my will to protect them.
Well said. That was all I needed to hear. I felt it when we crossed blades. Now I know. You have the strength of arm and the strength of heart to back up your words. Finally, my task is complete. My promise to my master is fulfilled.
What promise? What master? And what does this have to do with Yuma? What are you talking about, brother? Surely we deserve the truth by now.
The truth is, my master tasked me with watching over Yuma and the Shining Dragon.
Wait a minute! And all that crap about killing Yuma?
Hyperbolic aggression, of course. I had to push him beyond his boundaries.
You're kidding.
If Yuma had truly posed a threat to this land, rest assured, I would have killed him without hesitation. Thankfully, it seems that won't be needed. And now my master may rest in peace. Now then, I'll be taking my leave. My knights await.
Brother, wait!
Speak.
Don't you think you should continue to watch over Yuma? This war is far from over.
I still have my duties as captain of my knights.
Another knight might command just as easily, but nobody could watch over Yuma as you would.
No, perhaps not. I'll be watching over both you and Yuma. But I think it would be best if I kept my distance. For now, farewell.
Brother.
Leston, thank you.